want to learn about a type of breast radiation that you can get in one dose rather than over 4 to 6 weeks, we're going to teach you all about it. If you are going to have a lumpectomy surgery for breast cancer, there's a good chance you will need radiation therapy to lessen the chance that cancer grows back in that area of the breast. Whole breast radiation is still the standard of care and is given over about a 4 to 6 week period of time. But IORT, intraoperative radiation therapy, is offered at some hospitals and may be an option for you if you have a very favorable, small, early stage breast cancer. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you about what intraoperative radiation therapy is and how it's used for breast cancer. I'm going to share with you some of the potential advantages and also the possible disadvantages and concerns about IORT. I'm also going to share with you some of the qualifying features about breast cancer that may let you determine whether you are a candidate for IORT. So let's get started. What is IORT? Well, intraoperative radiation therapy is a type of radiation for breast cancer when someone has a lumpectomy. During surgery, and this is all planned in advance with you, a radiation oncologist, and your breast surgeon, but during your breast cancer lumpectomy, the surgeon removes the tumor with a good margin of normal tissue around it, and the radiation oncologist comes in and places a device for about 30 minutes while you're asleep in the operating room. And it irradiates the area where the tumor was to kill any cancer cells that might be there that might grow in the future. We call that a recurrence. So after they do the radiation and they close everything up and you're done with surgery, and if everything goes well after they look under the microscope and make sure everything's fine, it's felt to be a reasonable alternative to whole breast radiation over 4 to 6 weeks. I'm next going to tell you about the advantages and disadvantages and concerns about IORT. What are the potential advantages of IORT? Well, it's fairly obvious that if you have a surgery and radiation at the same time and you get them both done in one day, what a feeling. It's good to have so much of your cancer treatment done so quickly and efficiently. So it's potentially a time saver in that you can avoid whole breast radiation and the time it takes to travel to a radiation center Monday through Friday for 4 to 6 weeks, get undressed, have your treatment, which only takes a couple of minutes, but you have to do it over such a long period of time. And if you live a distance from a radiation center, that time commitment is very significant. We all have busy lives. The third potential advantage, and a lot of patients pursue IORT for their type of radiation rather than whole breast radiation, is that they like the concept that the radiation is given to the area where the tumor was, which is usually, if there are any cancer cells left behind, that's where they are, and just irradiate that area rather than whole breast radiation, which does irradiate the entire breast and the skin, and there's some side effects that can come with that. It's generally well tolerated, but a lot of people like that as a potential advantage of IORT. What are the disadvantages of IORT? Well, it is a new technology, so as such, we're learning more about it and how effective it is. The long-term success rate is good, but not yet felt to be as good as whole breast radiation therapy. So let me explain. If you have a surgical lumpectomy for an early stage breast cancer, and let's pick a number that the chance of something growing back in that breast, in the area where you had your surgery with whole breast radiation, is 6% over the next 5 to 10 years. That's still considered the standard of care. IORT has had trials, not yet out a long period of time to really calculate what the local recurrence rate is over the long term, but the local recurrence rate is just a couple of percentage points higher than whole breast radiation. Doctors debate and argue about it at breast cancer meetings all the time, so it's a very controversial subject. But in general, IORT has not been deemed to be as effective or equal to whole breast radiation. But there's a small difference, and it's really up to you to decide whether you want to go through and seek the advantages of IORT and maybe give off or give up a little chance, higher chance, of your breast cancer growing back in that area. Another potential disadvantage is that it is an invasive procedure. It's added to your surgery and it increases the chance of you having an infection after your surgery versus if you did not have IORT, because they're putting a device in your breast for an extended period of time. You can also have a cosmetic deformity in the area of the surgery and radiation, because radiation does make some changes in your breast. That doesn't happen all the time, but it's always a possibility with any surgery and a little bit more with this type of radiation. So when you look at it all, it's not yet considered standard of care. It's not incorporated into the guidelines for treatment. But it is an option, and it is approved, and if you feel like the benefits outweigh the risks for you with pursuing IORT rather than whole breast radiation, it's your choice. So do I qualify for IORT? If you have a very early stage one, and a few in stage two might qualify, and not everyone that has a stage one cancer is a candidate for IORT. So, small tumor, maybe less than 2 centimeters in size, receptor factors that are very favorable, like strongly estrogen receptor positive is something to know, and definitely HER2 receptor negative. You do not want to have this if there's any evidence or suggestion that you have cancer in your lymph nodes when you present to your surgeon. So, my advice to you is to only do this if you have a very, very, very favorable, what we consider low-risk cancer, which you'll have to find out from your surgeon and radiation oncologist. But beware, some radiation oncologists apply this new technology for just a few that we really feel would benefit most. And some radiation oncologists and surgeon will apply IORT to cancers that are a little bit more risky. And I think that that is something to try to avoid when you're seeking information about IORT. To learn more about intraoperative radiation therapy for breast cancer, visit the Breast Cancer School for Patients, where we teach you everything that you need to know. We're here to help you get the best possible breast cancer care in your community. Register on our website to get our list of questions to prepare you for your next doctor visit.